Why won't my program use more than 25% of the CPU? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. I'm running a very long Excel 03 spreadsheet. It can be configured to loop calculating alternatives for hours using an embedded basic program slash macro. I'm running this on a quad-core Intel with 4 GB. When I check in Task Manager, the system idle process will not drop lower than 75%, and the Excel process will max out at 25%. I've tried upping the priority of the process and have checked Affinity to ensure it's using all 4 processor cores. The Performance tab does show activity or load on all 4 processor windows. What's up? Why can't I utilize more than 25% of my system when I want to use it for a high priority and very lengthy task? This actually is, if you don't realize what's happening, it can be pretty frustrating. You spend all this money on a multi-core machine and it just sort of sits there poking along using one core. Why bother? Well, there are some good news aspects to this and some, I won't say bad news, but they're not going to be the answers you're looking for. So first we need to define what a core is. A CPU is the part of your computer that executes instructions, one after the other in sequence. So if you have one CPU, you can execute one stream of instructions at a time. You can have multiple CPUs in your machine. In fact, you can have multiple CPUs in your processor. Now, this is where the terminology gets a little confusing, but to continue with my approach, if you have multiple CPUs on a single processor, like you might have 4 CPUs on a single chip, a single processor, then you have 4 of these independent CPUs, each able to perform calculations independently of the others. Each has its own set of instructions that it's simply following one after the other after the other. What it means is that your computer can very, very literally do 4 things at once. Now, the reason I say it's confusing is because we also refer to these CPUs as cores. So a 4-core CPU is a 4-CPU processor. I totally get that the terminology is or can be confusing. That's not new when it comes to technology, I understand. But the bottom line here is that whether you call it a processor or a CPU, or you talk about cores or multiple CPUs, the bottom line here is that you've got 4 things that are capable of doing independent work at the same time. So, why aren't they? This is where it gets kind of interesting. First, I have to point out that when we say something is processor intensive, that it is the processor that is the limiting factor. Most of the time, this is not the case. If you're just typing email, browsing the web, doing something like that, there are other things that are taking more time, that are slowing your machine down. Typically, your processor spends most of its time waiting. That's the system idle process. It's just waiting. It could be waiting for another key at the keyboard. It could be waiting for some more information to come back down off the internet. It could be waiting for your hard disk to finish writing whatever it was just told to write. But the bottom line is that those things, in comparison to your CPU speed, are actually pretty slow. When something comes along that is processor intensive, it is something that you might consider to be math intensive or calculation intensive. Good examples, in addition to the Excel spreadsheet that you talked about in your question, are things like video encoding or audio encoding or compression or any of those kinds of things. That's all very heavy duty math. And that basically means that your processor is working hard to calculate those numbers. Why aren't all 4 processors being used? Well, unfortunately, software needs to be written to be multiprocessor aware. It needs to be written in such a way that it can make use of more than one core at a time. Unfortunately, it's not possible to take an arbitrary piece of software and spread its work over multiple cores. There are interactions that have to be accounted for that just doing that doesn't take care of. Multi-core software is written specifically to be able to use multiple cores. And indeed, many compression tools, many video encoding tools, many other processor-intensive software is written specifically to make use of all the cores available, if so instructed. Sometimes they even use other cores, your graphics processing unit, for example. But the bottom line here is that the software's got to know how to do it. If the software doesn't know about multi-core, or what's referred to as multi-threaded software, then it uses one core. That's all it knows to do. That's all it can do. And what that means is that on your quad-core system, it's using 25%, one core. On my 32-core system, it's using one core to do whatever it's doing, 1/32nd of the machine. Now, you mentioned that when you take a look at processor usage in a tool like Task Manager or my favorite Process Explorer, you'll actually see that one processor isn't actually pegged and flatlined at 25%. In fact, all of the processors are busy, but the sum total of their busyness doesn't exceed 25%. And that's all because of Windows internal process scheduling. It doesn't assign a task to a core. It simply swaps between tasks as needed and assigns them cores relatively randomly, which means that your one core process is bouncing back and forth between all of the cores that happen to be on your machine. But since it can only do one thing at a time, it's only going to use the one core that it's been assigned for as long as it's been assigned. So hopefully that helps you understand what's going on. Cores are very important when it comes to, like I said, processor-intensive, highly calculation-driven software like video editing, great example. In a lot of cases, when you're just doing stuff on the internet, writing email, browsing, you don't need the 16 or 32 cores. Four, in your case, is great. What that allows you to do is to have a process that actually hogs a full core's worth of your processor, and you can still use your machine because the other three cores are just sort of waiting for you to do something. Hope that helps understand a little bit of what's happening. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/17644. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.